Hello guys, welcome to Angular tutorial series from Intellipaat. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Bootstrap front-end framework. So the agenda of this video is going to be, we'll be talking about what is Bootstrap, why do we need it, what are the features and benefits are there if I use Bootstrap, and then obviously how to use Bootstrap in your Angular applications. So without wasting much time, let us start with what is Bootstrap. So what is Bootstrap? It's a simple free front-end framework developed by Twitter for faster and easier web development. So using Bootstrap, you can design your web applications and you can design them in a faster and easier way. The reason is Bootstrap comes with many CSS classes. Bootstrap comes with many JavaScript functions and all, so which you can call directly to beautify your pages. Second point is Bootstrap includes HTML and CSS based design templates for typography, forms, button, tables and all. So using Bootstrap, you can design your forms in a beautiful way. Similarly, buttons can come in a beautiful way. Like we have the classes as BTN, BTN-primary, BTN-danger. So the moment I say BTN-danger, it is going to create a button with a red background color with the round shaped, the corners of a button. So obviously it is going to beautify our pages if I'm using Bootstrap. Bootstrap also gives you the ability to easily create responsive design pages. So this point is very important because Bootstrap, you can create the responsive web pages. So before I jump to, the main features of Bootstrap, let me talk about what is responsive web design pages. This is something which is about creating websites which automatically adjust themselves to look good on all devices, from small phones to large desktops. So we know our application can be accessed by any of the machine. It can be large desktop, it can be small phone, it can be from any place we can access the any of the website. Now if I'm accessing the website from any of the device, so we have to make sure our application should be responsive, means it should be easily supported in large desktop. Similarly, it should be easily supported in the mobile phones also. That is what the responsive web design, that is what, it is not going to crop your pages. Suppose, you have created a website for the large desktops. So the moment when I open in the small phones, so it should not be cropped. The data should not be cropped, whereas the data should be shifted here and there to see the entire data of the website. So that is what responsive, based upon which all the device you are using, it is going to adjust itself. So this is what, either you can open those pages either in large desktop or small phones, anything. This is what getbootstrap.com is, the official website of Bootstrap, and just check out here. This is how it looks, right? And how to find out the size or the width of your device and all, you can, when you just take here and there, just check out here, it is 1031 pixel currently, right? And see, this is what automatically the design got changed. So initially it was like this, right? So the moment when I take, when I'm taking it little bit more, automatically the things are going to be changed. Check out here, now the image is coming over here and below we are getting the content. So it is shifting accordingly as and when I'm going to, decrease or increase the size of the page. So the reason is why, because it is a responsive web application, it is going to give the response for the different kind of devices. It is going to adjust automatically as and when the device is going to be changed. So how can we change device here? Just by changing the width of the application. Makes sense? So this is what, Bootstrap does. Using Bootstrap, you can create the responsive web pages. And check out what the website says here. Build responsive, the very important point here, mobile first project. Why mobile first? Because as it's responsive, you can open the websites in the mobile without cropping your data. On the web with the world's most popular front-end component library. So Bootstrap is nothing but, it is a front-end framework, free front-end framework. It is an open source. You can simply download it to start with your Bootstrap coding. Anybody with just basic knowledge of HTML and CSS can start using Bootstrap. So obviously prerequisite for Bootstrap should be basic knowledge of HTML and CSS. Obviously there is no, you should not be good in Angular to learn Bootstrap, but yeah, if you want to learn Angular, if you want to create the forms using Angular, you should be good in Bootstrap. Bootstrap responsive CSS adjusts to phones, tablets and desktop. That is what the responsive feature talks about. Mobile first approach in Bootstrap 3, mobile first styles are part of the core framework, so you can open the websites in the mobiles. Bootstrap is compatible with all modern browsers, Chrome, Firefox, Internet, all those things. It is going to be completely compatible with the different kind of different versions of the browser. Now let us talk about the prerequisite of Bootstrap. So from where to get Bootstrap, there are many ways to get the same. Either you can download the Bootstrap files from the getbootstrap.com website. Second could be, you can say download using npm. So there you can simply say npm install Bootstrap. So that will download the Bootstrap latest version package, and wherein you can see all bootstrap.css or bootstrap.js or all files related with the Bootstrap. Third way could be, you can include Bootstrap from a CDN. So any one of these three ways you can do to implement Bootstrap in your Angular applications. And this is what getbootstrap.com we know, right? Just click on this get started, and as I said, there are multiple ways. This is what you can do. This is what, using CDN, link rel equal to stylesheet and href. This is what your Bootstrap min.css file location in the website. Okay, so either you can just copy this code and paste it in your HTML page, you are all set to use Bootstrap in your application. So this is for the bootstrap.css. Another one is bootstrap.js. As I said, Bootstrap gives you not only the CSS files, it gives you the .js files also. The plugins, you know, the different kind of plugins we have it, like drop down plugin, we have it, we have model plugin, many things are there. So, but we'll be concentrating here more onto this bootstrap.css. So as I said, either you can download it in your system or you can use this CDN. So I'll be using this CDN link. Let us see what your first page should have. It should have a very important thing as meta tag. The reason why we need this meta tag, the reason is Bootstrap 3 is mobile first. The meaning is very simple. We can, when we are creating the websites using Bootstrap, they are going to be responsive. So how to make them responsive, this is what the important step over here. Meta name equal to viewport, content is equal to width equal to device hyphen width, width initial hyphen scale equal to 1. The meaning is very simple. The content of the page is telling the width of the page should be equal to your device hyphen width. So that is the reason we are making the responsive web page. The meaning is the width of the content, right, content of your page is going to be adjusted inside the device hyphen width. So device can be any kind of device. It can be large text, from large desktop to a small mobile, it can be anything. So the content has to be fitted inside that particular width, and this initial scale equal to 1 indicates here the initial zooming level. Later on you can zoom in, zoom out, whatever. So this line has to be there in your applications where you want to use Bootstrap. The another very important is Bootstrap also requires a containing element to wrap site contains. So you have to, whatever Bootstrap classes, all those things you are using, on which all the elements you are using, they all should be wrapped inside a element called which is having the classes called as container or container hyphen float. So the meaning is very very simple. Where all you want to implement the Bootstrap classes or Bootstrap plugins and all, make sure that particular piece of code should be enclosed inside a div element whose class name can be either container or it can be container hyphen float. The moment I say the class name is container, the meaning is we are providing a responsive fixed width container. So obviously it is going to be responsive, the width or the width of the container is going to be fixed. So all the content should be inside your fixed width container. The moment when I say container hyphen float as a class name for a div element, the meaning is we are spanning the entire width of the viewport. So the content can be inserted in the entire width of the viewport. Viewport is nothing but the device width, the device viewport is nothing but here the device width itself. Okay, so now let us see our very first page, our hello world page. Here we are using this meta name equal to all those things and link rel equal to style sheet. So here I am using CDN concept to implement this bootstrap.css file in my HTML page. And here we have written div class equal to container. As I said, either you can use container or container hyphen float. And these tags, you know, they are going to be defined, you know, some kind of definition will be there inside the CSS also. So let us just, I'll be showing you the example. Check out the, you know, the difference also. I'm going to create a HTML page over here. Head. And I'll say over here meta. Meta name equal to viewport. And it is going to be contained equal to width equal to device hyphen width. Comma initial hyphen scale equal to 1. This code I have already copied from the CDN link of your bootstrap.css. Let me write the body of the page and I'll just say div class equal to, as I said, there are two classes of container. One is container, another one is container hyphen float. And I'll just say, I'm just going to write a h1 element over here. The same example I'll show you later on with without bootstrap. Okay, so just execute this page. This is how it is coming up. Just check out the, you know, the font style. Do we get this kind of font style if I'm not using this? Okay, let me remove these two lines of code. And obviously I have to remove the class also, otherwise it will say it is undefined. See here, this is how I'm getting it, right? If I'm not using bootstrap, but if I use the bootstrap, we are getting in this way. Okay, so let me just open this link to check, do we have h1 defined over here? So let me just cross check here. See here, h1, h2, all those elements are defined. And this is what the definition, top is 0, margin bottom 5. That is the reason we are getting in the, you know, the center, right? And obviously the font style is also going to be different for the same font family, sorry. So that's how, you know, all your that's how you can see the difference between the a page using bootstrap and a page without using bootstrap. Okay, let us just see here. And as I said, like I just gave the example, we have the buttons classes, right? So let me create a button over here. If I'm just writing the button, okay, and I just say here my button, run the page, this is how it comes, right? Now the moment I'm going to use the bootstrap classes to define the buttons, we have many classes for, you know, specifically for buttons and all. BTN and BTN hyphen primary, they both are two separate classes, and I'm going to use the same here and check out the beautification of the button. So again, this entire definition is defined inside this that particular link, right? Inside this particular link. So you can just open this one again. I would like to show you this BTN hyphen primary definition. Just check out over here. Okay. Just see here, BTN hyphen primary, the font color is white, background color is blue, and the border color is again blue. Okay, and just check out for the BTN because you want to see the rounded corners also, right? So where is the BTN defined? It's here. Dot BTN, display inline block, font weight is something, font color is something, text align center, vertical align middle, WebKit, all those things. And then we have a border is there, padding is there, and font size, line height and border radius. So all because of this border radius, we are getting the rounded corners of a button. Makes sense? So that's how, you know, you can implement, you can use the Bootstrap features. You can, you know, write the Hello World application using the Bootstrap. The very first Bootstrap page we have written. In the next video, I'm going to show you the Bootstrap features, like, you know, nothing but how to create the different kind of buttons. Then we'll be talking about the forms. We'll be talking about how to create the tables. Many more features, and very important feature is the grid system. So that also I'll be talking about here. So that's it, guys, and thank you everyone. I'll see you in the next video.